Amnesia is a theme often portrayed in Hollywood movies.
It is a memory loss caused by psychological trauma,
disease,
or traumatic brain injury like a car accident.
There are two types of amnesia.
Retrograde amnesia, which is memory loss of past events,
and anterograde amnesia, which is the inability to form new memories.
The vow focuses on retrograde amnesia, so that's what we'll look into.
Retrograde amnesia splits up into two categories.
Pure retrograde amnesia
and temporally graded retrograde amnesia.
Pure amnesia usually shows no signs of anterograde amnesia.
Temporally graded amnesia is the more common of the two.
It shows some of the symptoms found in anterograde amnesia.
For example, the victim may find difficulty in retrieving recent memories.
This seems to be the type that the movie focuses on.
Research has vastly improved our knowledge on all things memory.
In temporally graded retrograde amnesia, there are three memory types that are usually affected.
The first is episodic memory, which is made up of an individual's experience in a lifetime, like prom night. This is usually the most affected memory type.
The second is procedural memory. This is made up of habits, skills, and how to do everyday things. This includes things like riding a bike. However, procedural memory is barely affected.
The last is semantic memory. This is reserved for facts and general knowledge, such as colors and the president of the country. This, too, is usually rarely affected.
It is easier to remember older memories than newer ones.
This is because older memories are strengthened through four steps.
The first is encoding.
This is the process of picking out key information to transfer into long-term memory.
The second is retrieval,
which is the process of taking information from long-term memory back into working memory.
The third is consolidation.
This is required because when new memories are made, they are in a vulnerable state. Consolidation makes them stable, allowing them to resist any disturbances.
And the last is reconsolidation.
This occurs when memories are retrieved back into working memory, putting them back into a vulnerable state, which requires consolidation again.
Now let's look into our movie of focus, The Vow.
This is based off of a real-life couple named Kim and Cricket Carpenter.
The couple wrote a book about their lives, which blossomed into this movie.
The main characters are Paige
and Leo.
In the beginning, they are driving in snow and get into a car crash.
Paige wakes up in the hospital with no memory of the last 5 years.
This includes the time period in which she meets and marries Leo.
She forgets that she left her family in the past.
And forgets that she also left her ex-fiancé, Jeremy.
She then struggles to decide with whom she should go home with.
Does she go home with her stranger husband?
Or does she go home with her parents?
In the end, she goes home with Leo.
When he takes her home, there is a party at the house.
This party overwhelms her and makes her very frustrated and irritated.
Leo didn't want us to overwhelm you.
Yeah, we were. Every day.
We really used to. I gather we're close. I'm Sonia. This is my boyfriend, Kyle.
Hey, Paige.
And this is Jim.
You look great, Paige.
And Lily. Hey, are you, like, working out at the hospital?
Hey, Paige.
And Josh. Excuse me.
Thank you all for coming. I'm sorry it ended early.
Paige attempts to retrace her memory by smelling perfumes,
rereading the vows she wrote on a brochure,
revisiting her art studio,
and exploring the city.
She begins to get too overwhelmed in such unfamiliar surroundings.
So she returns home to her parents.
She returns to law school, but realizes that she shouldn't be as she doodles in class.
An old friend later confesses to an affair with Paige's father.
This leaves her confused and saddened,
realizing that this was the reason she left all those years ago.
Her ex-fiancé, Jeremy, also confesses his love for Paige.
But she turns him down with the same reason that she left the first time,
saying she wants to discover life without him.
Such a familiar speech makes Jeremy question her memory loss.
She continues to reattend the Art Institute
and move back into the city,
just like how it was right before the accident.
The movie ends foreshadowing the return of Paige and Leo's love.
In conclusion, we thought that The Vow depicts retrograde amnesia fairly accurately.
Brain injury from the accident usually leads to memory loss.
Amnesia, mood swings, headaches, and migraines are typical symptoms of traumatic brain injuries.
All of which Paige portrays in the movie.
I help it figure out what it wants to be.
Okay. I don't really know how to use this thing.
Sure you do. Wait, hold on.
Paige's doctor gives accurate recommendations when she advises her to go back to a normal daily routine to regain her lost memories.
Paige also takes the right steps to regain her memory by exposing herself to significant items.
In theory, these important items will help jog her memory.
Her procedural memory is not affected.
Her semantic memory only incorrect for the current time period.
But her episodic memory is mostly affected.
All of which are typical effects of temporally graded retrograde amnesia.
However, we did find two inaccuracies.
It is very unlikely for Paige to pinpoint the very last memory she had, especially because it was so insignificant. Ordering toasted ravioli does not seem to be an important event to remember.
Also, traumatic brain injuries usually result in some symptoms of anterograde amnesia, which there was no mention of.
Therefore, overall, we think that The Vow depicts amnesia quite well without over-exaggeration or falsified information.
We hope you enjoyed our video
and maybe learned a little something about memory loss.
Thank you.